Hello again, everyone. This is Michael Cheek with Mike'sGuitarLessons.com. Today we're going to learn Kryptonite by Three Doors Down. And we're going to learn the intro here, but I'm calling it the intro, but it's used throughout the song a whole lot. So you're actually going to get a lot of use out of this little intro that we're going to learn at the beginning. It's basically based around three chords. It's going to sound something like this. And you just kind of repeat it. It changes a little bit at the end, but you just do it over and over again. Okay, now let's go ahead and get these chords out of the way that we're going to hold down, and then we'll go ahead and show you the picking pattern, okay? Our first chord is going to be this B minor. I'm not real worried about the chord names here since I'm just teaching a song, but this is a B minor that we're playing at the beginning here. And actually, for your sound, just to let you know, whatever guitar you've got is going to be fine. Electric is best, but and if you've got an electric, it's good if you can add some reverb, maybe just a touch of gain on the or distortion on the sound, and that'll cover you pretty good. But let's start off on this B minor. This B minor is actually a bar chord, but you don't necessarily have to play it as a bar chord because you don't use all the notes when you're doing the picking pattern. So I'm going to show you how to hold the chord down, and then I'll show you the other way you can play it. So what we're going to do here when you're playing it as a bar chord, you're going to bar in the second fret all the way across five strings. So that's the bottom five strings. You don't have to do the sixth string here. Now, barring is just where I'm holding down all the strings at once, okay? But to make the actual chord come out that we need, we're going to add these fingers here. So my middle finger, or my second finger, is going to play the third fret of the B string, okay? My fourth finger, or my pinky, whatever you want to call it, is holding down the fourth fret of the G string, and my third finger is holding down the fourth fret of the D string. Okay? So starting out here at the A string, I've got second fret. That's with my first finger. On the D string, I've got fourth fret. On the G, I've got fourth fret. On the B string, I've got third fret. And on the skinny E string, I've got second fret. Now, if you have trouble barring, you can just use this first finger to play this second fret on the A string, because we don't actually use that high E string when we're playing the picking pattern. Okay, so you're going to hold down your B minor. Let me actually show you the picking pattern for this chord, and then we'll go to the next one. So you're holding down your B minor chord, and you're going to start at the A string. Remember the string names. It's E string, B string, G, D, A. And this is the E as well, but I'll clarify it for you just by calling it the thickest E string, and this is the skinny E string. Really, you'd call this sixth string E and first string E. Okay? Now, you're going to start off the intro by holding down this chord, this B minor, and you're going to start at the A string. Okay? Nothing changes down here, just hold your notes down, and then here on the A string with your right hand, pluck that note, then pluck the D string, then the G, then the B. Okay? So just like that. A, D, G, B. Okay? Now you let that B string ring for a second, and then you go back to the G, then the D. Okay? So. So it's A, D, G, B, G, D. Then you can kind of just, you're going to go to a G chord for your next one, but as you come off that chord, you can go ahead and hit open on the G string. Okay? So that gives you time to get to your next chord. Okay? So watch both of my hands here. Again, that was third string G open. And then you're going to hold down a G chord. The only two notes you have to have when you're playing this pattern is your middle finger on the third fret of the thick E string and your first finger on the second fret of the A string. Okay, that one right there. Now, if you're going to play a full G chord, you want to take your third or your fourth finger and put it on the third fret of the E string down here. Okay? But everything else is open. But again, for the picking pattern, if you're strumming this later in the song, you can hold that one down. But if you have trouble putting that G chord down fast enough, then you don't have to put that one down right away, okay? So after you play the first chord, you're going to hold down your G chord. Again, second fret on the E string, and then, third fret on the C string, and then second fret on the A string. And I forgot to mention that the D, G, and B strings are open, okay? So once you play that open G, after the B minor chord, and you've gotten your, you know, that gives you time to get your G chord down. Then you're going to play the thick E string, then the A string, then the D string, then the G string again. So just 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So putting those together, it's going to sound like this. And then you're going to hold down this the variation of an A chord here, and really pick whichever fingers you're comfortable with here. I'm just going to go ahead and play it this way. So what we've got here is our second finger is going to go on the second fret of the D string, playing this note. Okay, and our third finger is going to go on the second fret of the G string, playing that note. Now, once you hold that chord down, this comes right after that G chord. You're going to play open on the A string. Then you're going to play the D string, which you've got pressed down on the second fret. Okay? Then you're going to play the G string, which you've got pressed down in the second fret. And then you're going to play the B string, which is open. So it's just 1, 2, 3, 4. A string, D string, G string, B string. And then you start it over. Okay, so let me go through it slowly. And you start it over. Alright. Now, that's used a whole lot during the song. And one last thing that happens sometimes at the end of the riff. At the beginning of the song, they play it that way normal, the way I just showed you, three times in a row. But then the very last time they actually play it, they change the last chord a little bit. Instead of going on that A, it's not exactly an A, but instead of playing that, what they're doing is playing the A string, and then they're going open on the E string, then the B string, then the G string. And I know that G sounds kind of weird there, but they don't let it ring very long, and that is the actual note. I'm for sure, because I went ahead and made sure that was it. It kind of sounds weird, but that's what they do that fourth time. They go through it, and then I think it's every other time or something like that throughout the song. But just go ahead and learn that that little extra part. So that if you do it that way, it's going to sound like... And then you go back into it again. Alright, so I hope you understood all of that. Again, I'm going to make more videos for this song because I'm not done with it. And you can catch those videos at www.mikesguitarlessons.com. I hope you enjoy the video. Practice it hard. We've got plenty of other videos on the website. I think I shouldn't say a number right now, but I've got, because this video I plan on leaving up. So, just to let you know, though, we've got hundreds of videos on the website. I've got a song list in the bottom left-hand corner of the homepage at www.mikesguitarlessons.com, and I hope to see you there. Thanks a lot.